Hello guys, welcome back to another video. I want to take this time to expand your point of view because there are certain things you can learn in church or in other places, because these things are more spiritual than physical. For the past 2 or 3 days I've been sick, so I've not been able to come live or record some videos. Yeah, so just listen to me. On the last video I already commented, someone said something like, there is no way that Suki Hana can be alive and be in hell. Now let me expand your point of view. Okay, let's forget about religion, let's forget about all these things, because this is purely spirituality. This is about spirituality. So please, I want you guys to lose your mind, lose your religious mind and all your ideas, because you know religion is more about the positive part, okay, the good part, but they don't really go ahead and speak about the bad part. And for certain reasons, because if they really go ahead and expose the dark side, believe me, more people will not go to church. So with that said, let's get right into it. Basically, there's something which we call out of body experience. Don't forget, a human being is composed of 3 parts. That's your body, your soul, your spirit. And in certain cases, your soul can leave your body and travel to different realms. Okay, it can go to different spiritual realms and come back to that same body. And they don't really tell you this in church, mosque, whatever religion you are. But I think the new ages or those on the dark side, they know a lot about these things. They know a lot about astral projecting. They know a lot about leaving your body, you know, leaving your physical body and going around different realms. That is called astral projecting, where you're actually leaving, your soul is actually leaving your body and going to the spiritual realm. Actually, in the spiritual realm, there is no time. Time is constant. So you can go to the past, you can go to the future, you can go behind time, know whatever happened behind time, and you can even come back and go to the future and you know everything. And that's what these guys do. The Illuminati, they know about this thing so much. That's why they can predict the future. That's why the New Agers too can predict the future. That's why even spiritual Christians too can predict the future. It all depends on your level of spirituality. So what they don't tell you is that you can leave your body and go to hell and come back to your body. They don't tell you that in church. Okay, and please now listen to me carefully. These people that work on the dark side, the Illuminati, the occult, those people, they work with Satan, okay? They work hand in glove with Satan. And if you don't know, these people leave their body in the night, I guess around 12 a.m. Sometimes they go to hell. They go to hell. I want to be very honest with you here, because they don't tell you this in church. They don't tell you this in other places. But people go to hell and come back in their physical body. Okay? They are working with the dark side. They are on the dark side. But they go to hell. They even make meetings in hell. They do their things in hell. Is a very big place, okay? It's not only just about suffering, and hell is a very big place. They got different things that they do in hell. They even produce certain things that you use on earth in hell. They are selling company logos in hell. So most of these ideas that you have seen on earth is coming from hell directly, and these people go down there. They meet Satan, they meet demons, they collaborate with demons and Satan, and they come back on earth. Don't forget, a human being, Listen to me very carefully, okay? It's when you're dead. It's when you're dead, that's when you're trapped, okay? It's when you're dead, that is when you're actually trapped and you can come back to your physical body. But if you're still alive, you can actually leave your body. That's what you know about all these new agers. They know what I'm talking about. All these occult people, spiritual people, they know what I'm talking about. You can actually leave your body, travel around these different realms, come back to your same body. It happens all the time. It happens every single night, man. And I'm just trying to expand your point of view, because people feel like, hell is only a place for suffering. Oh, when you go to hell, you can never come back. Listen to me very carefully. People go to hell and come back every single day, and they do it every single day. People go to heaven and come back every single day. If you don't know, but the issue is that God is a global God, okay? God is omnipotent, omniscience, omnipresent. So he don't necessarily need you to come to heaven to discuss with you or to give you an idea or tell you certain things, okay? God can come to you in your dream. But Satan is not omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscience. So Satan really is restricted in its movement. So these people, they meet in certain places, they meet in certain depths of hell, and they do certain things, they do certain meetings, and they are doing every single thing in hell, and they actually see people burning in hell, and they know about those things, but they are being brainwashed. They're not being told that very soon they too will burn in hell. Okay, I've seen a lot of people that have been in hell. They were on the dark side, they were occultists, they were magicians, they also went to hell, and I've seen people burn in hell, but they came back to the physical body and they were still doing the same things because they were on the dark side. And when you're on the dark side, you're being brainwashed. They can't tell you the truth. When you're on the dark side. So it's when you're dead from your physical body completely, when you know you can't have any physical access into this world, that is when you're trapped in hell forever. But as long as you're living on earth, people who are occultists, I know that watching me right now, devil worshippers, they know that they are always traveling to hell, coming back. They go to different realms and they come back all the time. They do that every single day. I know some of you guys must have heard about all these testimonies on people saying how they went to heaven and God showed them heaven. God showed them even their house in heaven while they are still living on earth. There are certain times that God can take you to the future and show you certain things. God can take you to the past and show you certain things. He can even show you your house in hell, your place in hell. And does this because he just loves you and he just wants to warn you. I think there's certain things that they don't really say in church because they know if you want to talk about the dark side, those are preaching about sin and more people will leave the church. That's what happens. That's what really happens. And please, listen to me carefully. Demons also leave hell and come on earth. They do that every single day. And they come on earth using certain, portals. And it all depends on you, because if you open a portal, they will come through that portal and they will torment your life. Actually, they are living hell. They come with different weapons on earth and they can influence you to use those weapons and destroy yourself. It happens every single day. They will not tell you this in church. They only tell you in church that angels leave heaven, they come on earth and they bring your blessings. But they don't also tell you that the same way as angels are leaving heaven and coming on earth with your blessings, the same way demons are also leaving hell and coming on earth to destroy you. They won't tell you this in church, but I want you guys to know. I want you to expand your point of view so that you can block those portals, so that those things will not affect your life, because many Christians are being affected by certain things that they don't even know, because they only know about the good side, but pastors don't go around telling them the dark side, the evil side, things that can actually affect them. It's not to make you scared, it's to make you to be wise so that you can actually stop these things from coming to your life and destroy you, because they are here to destroy you. And if you don't know these things, come on, they will destroy you. I've seen this thing destroy a lot of people, and really, I don't even know what to say, because... So, there's also one thing which I want to let you guys know. Some of these angels have human form. In fact, they take upon the human form and they move around the earth. Like, believe me, if you're like 21 years old, believe me, you have come across many angels in your life without even knowing, because they won't come in their angel form. I hear people saying stuff like, oh, my guiding angel. Shut up your mouth. There's nothing like your guiding angels, okay? They are saying stuff like, oh, I'm praying to my guiding angel. Bro, you don't have any guiding angel. It's God that is giving permission to a guiding angel to come and guide you. It's not you calling upon your guiding angel. It's God's angel. So he can send his guiding angels upon you. Certain times he don't even need to send a guiding angel upon you, but people have brought upon these ideas in their minds. I don't know where it's coming from in the first place, man. But anyways, angels do use human form in this realm to operate, as well as demons, man. Angels, they go around, they use human form. In fact, that's what I said, most of you guys have seen angels, but you will not know. That's why the Bible says that. That's why Jesus Christ said that. Don't forget to entertain strangers, because some of them might be angels. And if you read the Bible very well, in the Old Testament, most of the time that angels came to human, they came in a human form. Demons too also use human form, because demons were fallen angels. They still have those abilities, so they use human form to operate. That's why most of these people that you see around, they are demons, man. They're not human beings, they're demons. You will not know because your spiritual eyes are closed, bro. Your spiritual eyes are closed. That's why I'm trying to like wake you guys up so that you will not fall into these traps of demons. And some of the time you see angels, they'll beg you for food. You're not, please, bro, learn to be very kind. Sisters, learn to be very kind. Help people, because some of them are angels. And when you help people, you have a great reward in heaven. So don't go around, like, your stingy attitude will not help anybody. It will mess you up in the later days. So let me go back to my topic. That's why I'm highly bent on the fact that some of these religions are just deception. Because if your spiritual eyes were open, believe me, there is nothing like Buddhist, Muslim, Christian. There are only two sides, man. There are only two sides of this story, okay? It's God and Satan, that's it. It's God and Satan, that's it. That's the battle on this earth. It's only between God and Satan. And really, I don't care about most of you guys, because some of you guys come up with all your ideas on religion. Oh, I'm from this religion. Oh, there are many religions in the world. People have their point of view. It's not about your point of view, bro. This thing is deeper than you can ever imagine. It's bigger than you. It's bigger than what you can ever think about or you can ever imagine. But once you've gone to the dark side, once you've seen these things, you know that this thing is not something you have to joke around with. You can't joke with these things. This is your eternity. Guys, there's only one way to heaven, and that's through Jesus Christ. And there's only one way to hell, that's through Satan. And he's currently taking a lot of souls to hell. And really, I do know I'll get a lot of hate from people because people have their own ideas. But guys, it doesn't matter. The takedown of this video is that I want you guys to expand your point of view. Live like a true child of God. And don't forget, you are in a spiritual battle. So don't only look about the good part, also prepare yourself for the bad part. That's what the Bible says, that always put on your full armor of God so that nothing can affect you. It is written in black and white, because we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, we wrestle against principalities and powers in the heavenly places.